Hey guys, in this tutorial we will customize the app's look and feel by using the Bootstrap classes. So as you can see on the post list view, we have only one column which spans 12 columns per row. We will use two columns instead of one column of medium size devices with six columns each. So open up the Atom text editor. We don't need the hello world here. We have already applied Bootstrap CDN here, so it will work. Now create div tag. Inside the div tag, we need to create a class container fluid for fixed full width of the web page. We'll use full width, and then we will create a grid. According to the grid system, we will need to create a row which are readily available, and just cut and paste the for loop inside the row so that the changes may take effect. After the for loop, we need to create a column which is called md6 for two equal columns that may adds up to 12. And if we refresh the browser, we'll see two equal columns appears for each post. We can be used three equal columns like this, but we will stick with two columns. So our post list view is now looking somewhat good. We'll use CSS to make the page more pretty, but before that we need to use thumbnail so that it will look somewhat good. So inside the column md6, we'll create a thumbnail which is the img-thumbnail readily available in the Bootstrap class, which is inside the div. We'll use img-thumbnail to separate each post inside the layer like this. For title, we'll use anchor tag. We'll give the URL afterwards and just place the title inside the A tag, and we'll create a small tag here for our p.createdDate, which can be placed after the title, and the author will place it in paragraph tag, or we can say author here, and write br tag. We will place the content of the body inside the b tag, which is the paragraph tag. We don't need p.updated in the post list view for now. If we refresh the browser again, we can see our post is now somewhat looking good. We will use PR here as well. See, instead of using paragraph tag, we will use simple body. Now it is looking somewhat good. Just update br tag here as well to separate each and every post with like this. And for this, we will use CSS to make the page more pretty. For this, we finally use static files concept. Aside from the HTML generated by the server, web applications generally need to serve additional files such as images, JavaScript, or CSS necessary to render the complete web page. In Django, we refer these files as static files. First, create a directory called static in your blog directory. Static. Django will look for static files in this directory. Within the static directory we have just created, we need to create another directory called blog for our application. And just rename the static here. We have misspelled the static here. And inside that blog application, blog directory, we need to create a file which is name it style.css. So we'll first create HTML inside this style.css, position should be relative and height, minimum height should be 100%. For body, we'll use font family. For our entire text, we'll use font family here. We'll use Lucida casual comic sans MS. We need to load the static template tag at the very top of the post list.html. After the doc type html, using curly brackets, inside the curly brackets we need to double percentage sign and then write load static keyword. We need to link the style.css in the head tag using link relation style sheet, and in the hyper reference we'll give the static path using percentage static keyword, then the inverted commas, the path, the block directory inside the static directory block, which is style.css. If we refresh the browser again, we'll see the changes now affected, and the font body is using the Lucida casual font family. So our static files are just working now here. In Django, you could have a static folder almost anywhere you want. You can even have more than one static folder. For example, one in each app. However, to keep things simple, we will just use one static folder in the root directory of our project MySite instead of using in each application. Open up the settings.py file of the MySite directory, and at the very end of the page, just write static underscore doors. Excuse me, it's static files underscore doors, which is a tuple itself. We'll need to join the path of the base directory with the static folder itself that we will create just now. os.path dot static. It's join. To join. The base directory variable, and then the static that we will create inside the root directory of the MySite project, and then we'll also create static underscore root for our static files when we go live or when we use in production. Dot part dot join base job static files. So just use this static folder in the MySite directory. We have just moved the static directory one level up. Now static files are here, available here, which is pointing static files JS will look in this static directory of the root project. The static files JS tuples Django where to use where to look for static files that are not tied to a particular app. In this case, we told Django to look for static files in static folder here instead of in each every app. We can also use static folder in every app. Okay, so Django also provides a mechanism for collecting static files in one place so that they can be served easily using the collect static command. So open up the terminal and run python manage.py collect static, hit enter. You can see 62 static files copied to home Abhishek blog project MySite directory static files. Static files has now been created here, which has the admin static files and the blog's static files, which is style.css. It will gather all static files into the folder called static files. into a folder called static files. This is useful for serving static files in production settings. So if we refresh the browser again, first of all we need to run the server. Refresh the browser again, we can see that the static files are working. So we are all good. We have used how to manage or serve static files in our project. This is it, guys. Bye bye.